The enjoyable Alan Nachman is here for the weekly options alert. Hello, Alan. You have been talking up this market for a while, and here we are.
Hi, Angie. Another beautiful breakout for the bulls. Well, at the start anyways, didn't finish that well, but it is a new relative high in the S&P yesterday.
How are your trades shaping up with your WPI trade tracker?
Let's talk about what we have. August positions, Oxy, breakout in crude yesterday, Micron, MU, and then we've got Oracle and AMD, which we've already taken our standard profit if we get a 50% gain. So we're looking for some more there. Also, September plays. September has 2 months of time. Cisco, which was about a dollar away from a swing high, it's looking to fill in that gap at the $50, and this option should give us a nice big payoff.
This week, your WPI trade trigger is focused on Twitter.
The trade trigger today is Twitter time. Now, we do have earnings. It's not an earnings play. It's a September option, so it's got 2 months. We might see the earnings as a catalyst here. The Twitter was actually negative coming into this week. In the last year of trade, it's really been stuck between 20 and 40 for 8 months. That puts a super support level at 30. So we're looking at the September 30 call, 2 months of time, and it was only $75 more than buying the August, which was more susceptible to whatever happens immediately with earnings.
Now that we're set with your trade this week, what are your trading day takeaways?
Trading takeaway number one, shy by 50. Our NDX indicator, which is leading the way, was within 50 points yesterday of its all-time forever highs made Monday a week ago. Now, that drop from that high to this recent swing low sets up for a 700-point pop if we can make new highs once again. Number two, crude calm. Crude oil had been going nowhere for the last couple of weeks, but holding above that important 40 point, which is the halfway level of the action for the last year, from $60 all the way down to 20. Now, 40 is a midpoint. We've been staying above that. But more importantly, what happened yesterday in the September contract filled in a gap that we had from February at 42.50. So that's a very positive sign. And that looks like the next stop might be 50 as a barometer of economic confidence. And three is the S&P surge. Like I said, a breakout to some new relative swing highs. Speaking about gaps, I'm a technical trader and I like what I see. We're holding above the 3200 level very solidly. There's a gap up above at 3328, which was from February 21st close to the open on the 24th. So if we can fill that gap, remember that was only 2 days after the all-time forever highs, which were made at 3390. So it looks like the markets may be setting up for another S&P surge.
Thank you so much, Alan, and have a great one.
Thank you.